Hey there, photography enthusiasts. Welcome back to our new video. Today, we're diving into Adobe Lightroom A masking with practical examples. We'll cover everything from people masking to sky replacement and more. Let's enhance your photos. Grab your camera and let's get started. People masking. Let's start with people masking. Import any people image in Lightroom. If you've ever wanted to take your portrait editing to the next level, you're in the right place. All right, folks, let's get started. I've imported a portrait I shot recently into Lightroom. First things first, make sure you've got the latest version of Adobe Lightroom. Updates are essential to access these amazing features. Now, let's zoom in on our subject's face. You can do this by clicking on the zoom tool on the bottom right, or just by using your mouse's scroll wheel. Got a good view? Great. Now, head over to the Develop module by clicking on Develop at the top right. Here's where the real magic happens. Look to the right panel, and you'll find the People section. Click on Face to expand it. Lightroom uses its AI-powered people detection to automatically identify the people in your photo, as well as isolated the body parts. In this particular shot, it's recognized a single person. If you have multiple people or group, no worries. They'll all be listed here. Click on the cloths you want to enhance or change, and then click on Create button. And voila, Lightroom creates a red mask. That's the people mask. This is your canvas for precision editing. Need to adjust the mask visibility? Easy peasy. Use the mask overlay options. The cloths are red and your mask overlay is also red. You can change masking color, make the mask more prominent, or you can choose other options, black on white or white on black, etc. All right, we've got our canvas set up. Now, let's work some editing magic on the cloths. For this demonstration, I will change the cloth colors. To do that, go to the hue bar and move the slider to select your desired color. I'm selecting here blue. My cover overlay is blue, so if you want to see the selected area, change to red again. I'll brighten the eyes and smooth the skin a bit. To do that, head over to the mask panel within the People Mask options. In People Mask options, you'll find various facial features like eyes, mouth, and skin. Let's start with the eyes. Click on Eyes. Click on Eyes Sclera to unveil the options. Here, you've got sliders for brightness, whiteness, and detail. I'm going to subtly increase the brightness to make those eyes pop. You can also change the intensity of masking by moving slider. Looking good, right? Now let's smooth the skin. Click on Skin to access those settings. Within the skin settings, you'll find sliders for skin, smoothing, texture, and clarity. Let's gently smooth the skin to remove minor imperfections. And there you have it. We've enhanced the eyes and smoothed the skin, all while keeping the rest of the photo intact. But hold on, there's more. You can fine-tune your people mask with the brush tool. Need to include or exclude specific areas from the mask? Simply select the Subtract or Add Brush tool and paint over the areas you want to adjust. This level of precision is incredible, isn't it? Once you're satisfied with your edits, click on Basics Editing and see before and after. In this image, you edited a single person. Imagine you have a group photo with one person slightly underexposed. Here's how you can fix it. Open your photo in Lightroom. Go to Edit and find the People section. Click Select Subject to automatically detect the person. I have selected a desired person. Adjust the saturation. Clarity increase the exposure. Shadows to brighten up and enhance the selected person. You can also do selective edit of any other part of the person as we did before. Lightroom People Masking is a great tool for photographers, vloggers, influencers, or anyone who loves taking photos of people. And here it is, the brand new sky masking feature for 2023. Click on Enable Sky Mask. Lightroom will automatically detect the sky in your image. It's like magic. You'll see a preview of the mask, highlighting the sky. But here's the cool part. You can fine tune it further. Select a sky mask and open right menu. Select Intersect Mask with Luminance Range. A new panel opens up with slider, Luminance Range. And with Sky Luminance Range, you control how much of the sky is considered. Slide it to the right for a broader range or to the left for a more specific selection. Now you can select sky color range by intersecting mask with color range. With sky color range, you can adjust the sensitivity of the color detection. Slide it to the right to include more colors. Once you've refined the mask to your liking, go to sky mask again. Now let's enhance that sky. You can adjust various settings like exposure, contrast, saturation, and more to give your sky that wow factor. For this photo, I'll increase the contrast and saturation to make the sky more vibrant and dramatic. Wow, what a difference. But remember, you can fine tune the mask anytime by clicking on the intensity slider and adjusting the settings. Once you're satisfied with your edits, click on Basic Settings. And there you have it, folks, the all-new sky masking feature in Lightroom Classic 2023. It's a game changer for landscape photographers, and I'm super excited about the creative possibilities it offers. Object masking. I've imported a photo that's perfect for demonstrating object masking. This new feature is designed to make your editing workflow more efficient and precise. First, zoom in on the object you want to mask. You can do this using the zoom tool on the bottom right, or simply by scrolling with your mouse. Once you have a good view of your subject, head over to the Develop module by clicking Develop at the top right. Now, let's reveal the object masking panel on the right side. Click on Object Mask. Here's where the magic begins. Click on Enable Object Mask. You need to paint over the object that you want to edit. Lightroom Classic will select the object in your photo. It's like having your own selection assistant. Now, let's make some edits to our object. You can adjust various settings like exposure, contrast, saturation, and more, knowing that your edits are only affecting the object you've masked. For this photo, I'll increase the highlights, saturation, and change hue to make the brass pop. You can fine tune further. Click on Intensity Slider. These sliders allow you to increase or decrease the intensity of editing. Once you're satisfied with your object mask, go to Basic and see Before and After Effects. And there you have it. We've made precise edits to the object while leaving the rest of the image untouched. And that's how you use object masking in Lightroom Classic. It's a fantastic tool for isolating and enhancing specific objects in your photos. Subject masking. I'm going to show you how to use the subject masking feature in Lightroom to create stunning effects and edits. Subject without affecting the rest of the image. Let me show you how it works. First, you need to open your image in Lightroom and go to the Develop module. Then, click on the Select Subject button at the top of the toolbar. This will automatically detect and select the main subject of your image. You can see the selection outline in red. You can also refine the selection by using the brush tool or the eraser tool to add or remove areas from the selection. Next, you can apply any adjustments you want to your subject. For example, you can increase the exposure, contrast, clarity, or saturation to make your subject pop out more. You can also use the color mixer or the color grading tools to change the color or mood of your subject. You can see the before and after effects by toggling the switch at the bottom of the panel. Finally, you can also apply adjustments to the background or the inverse of your selection. To do this, you need to click on the invert button at the top of the toolbar. This will switch the selection from your subject to everything else in your image. Then, you can use the same tools and sliders to modify the background as you wish. For example, you can blur the background, darken it, or change its color to create a contrast with your subject. And that's how you use the subject masking feature in Lightroom. All right, folks, here we are in Adobe Lightroom Classic. I've got an image open, and we're going to walk through the process of background masking step by step. But before we get started, make sure you hit that subscribe button and ring the notification bell so you never miss out on awesome photo editing tutorials like this one. Background masking, the new AI background masking feature. If you're a photography enthusiast or a professional photographer like me, you're in for a real treat. This feature is a game changer for your photo editing workflow. So make sure to stay tuned. And as you can see, there's something brand new that's got everyone talking, the AI background masking tool. This feature leverages the power of artificial intelligence to simplify and supercharge your background masking process. Let's dive right in and see how it works. First things first, select the image you want to work on. I've chosen this beautiful portrait shot with a somewhat complex background to put the AI background masking to the test. Next, head over to the Develop module, just like we usually do when editing photos. Now, here's where the magic happens. Meet the AI background masking tool, represented by this wand icon. It's prominently placed in the toolbar for easy access. Simply click and hold on the AI background masking tool, and you'll see it work its AI magic in real time. It quickly analyzes your image, identifies the subject, and creates a precise mask, separating the subject from the background. To get a clear view of your mask, you can use the mask overlay by pressing O on your keyboard. This will help you see exactly which areas have been masked. Need to make some touch-ups or refine the mask? No problem. Subtract areas from the mask manually. The AI background masking tool works hand in hand with your creativity. Now that we've effortlessly separated our subject from the background, we can focus on making adjustments to either element, enhance the background, change its color, or even replace it entirely to achieve your desired look. The possibilities are endless. And there you have it, the new AI background masking feature in Adobe Lightroom, Classic 2023. It's a game changing addition that streamlines your editing workflow and allows you to achieve professional-level results with ease. There you have it, practical examples of Lightroom AI masking for people. Sky replacement, objects, subjects, and ranges. These tools empower you to transform your photos and bring your creative vision to life. So get out there, capture amazing shots, and edit them with confidence using Adobe Lightroom's powerful AI masking features. If you found this video helpful, remember to like, subscribe, and share it with fellow photographers. And as always, if you have any questions or suggestions for future videos, drop them in the comments below. Happy editing!